Hey everyone, it's been a while. Today we're going to do something new. Let's unbox this iMac here. Then I'm going to share the customization process. I will walk you through the options and give the reason why I choose them. Let's go. Now we're looking at the available ports. We have 3.5 headphone jack, SDXC card slot, 4 USB-A ports, Thunderbolt 3, and Ethernet port. So this is our headphone jack and SDXC card reader and 4 USB-A ports. Thank you Apple for that. And we have here the Thunderbolt, just 2. Why? Just 2. And our gigabit Ethernet. I have upgraded mine to 10 gigabit. So that is your RG45. And of course here are memory slots. You can open that up for your upgrade, self-upgrade. And Kensington lock slot. Use with Kensington cable lock, you can buy it somewhere else like Best Buy to secure your iMac. And our AC power port, where we're going to insert the AC power cord. Alright, push it here and just push it gently. There you go. Alright, just checking to make sure it is inserted all the way. And it is. And lastly, our power button. There you go. Classic Apple branding. Sleek and minimalist. Let's check this magic mouse too first. Just from here, you can feel what makes this mouse unique. Just look at that. So aesthetically beautiful. This is now built-in rechargeable. You can use lightning port for charging using the USB lightning cable. This is a multi-touch surface, means all of these are touch sensitive. Excellent design. According to Apple, these two strips here, see this? It is referred as optimized foot design. It will help track user. Now let's move to this guy. Sleek design as usual, lightweight, very portable, but yet it has a solid feel. Switching between Mac and iMac should not be a problem, the design were identical. Alright, this is also a built-in rechargeable, just use the lightning cable to charge this. Alright, let's see what else. Okay, let's check what else in the box. Pull this out. Who knows, they put some money here, right? Nope. Open this up. Oh, hello iMac. But I need this one at the back. Polishing cloth. Thank you. There you are. Lightning to USB cable. You can use this lightning cable to charge your magic keyboard, magic mouse too. Or your iPhone, iPad. It is a standard lightning cable. Okay, next. Stickers. Gotta love the stickers. I'll keep them. Welcome to your iMac. Thank you. You are so expensive, but worth it. Alright, that's all in the box. Well, let's turn this on. iMac arrived with macOS Catalina pre-installed, so we're going to upgrade it to macOS Big Sur. There you go, it's now upgraded. Now for the second part of this video. These are the three base configurations. Available as starting point or can be ordered as is. I categorize them as entry level, mid level, and high level. Just please do note that these levels is just in the context of my Mac alone. And at any rate, even the entry level spec is more than enough for any typical use. Now, with that being said, I started with high level as it meets the criteria of what I am looking and needed it for. The base configuration for this level is 3.8 GHz, 8-core i7 processor. Now, let's go through the customization process and I'll throw in my reasons for choosing a specific option. Let's start with display, no question. It will be 27-inch. I find it as a perfect size for me. I tried 21, too small for the work and things I do. I choose standard glass. I actually prefer the glossy glass than matte. It will save me $500 too. It's a personal choice, nothing else. Now, for the CPU. The processor, the brain, the workhorse, the power. I choose 3.8 GHz, 8-core i7 here, that's a monster already. And to point out, I can't really justify upgrading it for additional $400 for possibly 10-20% plus minus gain. It is good to have, but not a deal breaker. 8-core i7 is already a beast for my need. I don't see myself doing semi-pro work on video editing. i7 is more than enough for my professional and personal projects. Bit made software development or anything else. Now, for memory, this is where I got excited. I choose to get the standard 8 GB and just look at the prices. It will blow your mind, right? What I will do is I'm going to buy third party 64 GB. It's a 2 32 GB memory sticks, and take note of this as I really suggest you do the same. I'm going to replace 8 GB and just use 2 32 GB because for me, 8 GB will not matter much. If you are in the realm of 64 GB, no need to combine them. That way it will just one brand, two slots, and two more left for future upgrade. You will not worry about interference or integration. Also, buying 64 GB third-party memory will save me $700. Yay! I will replace install it myself. I will even post it. Watch out for it. For storage, I am fine with 512 GB. You can go 1 TB for just additional $200. Highly recommended. It will be worth it. For my case, I already have existing external storages, SSDs and HDDs. I'm planning to build my own NAS server as well. Graphics. Now, this is worth upgrading for. Although 5500 XT standard GPU is already enough, yet I'm still willing to shell out additional $500 as the Radeon Pro 5700 XT has a very good performance review. Then, on top of that, you got double memory size at 16 GB GDDR6. It allows you to extend or connect up to 2 6K monitors. Remember, GPU plays a very important role, and technically, it plays a very specific role. This GPU upgrade will allow me to freely edit 4K videos and more. This is one of the worthy upgrades you can do. For Ethernet, as part of future-proofing as well, I upgraded it to 10 gigabits for additional $100. Alright, to summarize, this is what I got. A 27-inch Retina 5K, 3.8 GHz, 8-core Intel Core i7, 8GB DDR4 memory, 512GB SSD, and Radeon Pro 5700 XT, 16GB DDR6, and 10GB Ethernet. This specs is future-proof. It will be good for the next 3 years. This should be able to survive hardware and software upgrades 3 or more years after that. This is all I have. Hopefully you get an idea or two. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.